برطانیہ کی سرزمین سے ہمارے مہمان تشریف فرما ہوئے ہیں، جامعہ الازہر مصر کے طالب ہیں اور ایک عظیم الشان دسدہ کالج یونیورسٹی کے استاد ہیں جو نوٹنگم جامعہ الکرم، اور یہ حضور ضیاء الامت کا ایک فیضان ہے، آپ کے والد گرامی حضرت قبلہ پیرزادہ امداد حسین صاحب وہ ہستی ہیں کہ جنہوں نے انگلش کے اندر پہلی تفسیر قرآن برطانیہ کے اندر جنہوں نے لکھی ہے، اور الحمدللہ بخاری شریف کو بھی انگلش کے اندر وہ ٹرانسلیٹ کر رہے ہیں۔ آپ کے نور چشم حضرت قبلہ شیخ بختیار حیدر پیرزادہ صاحب جو خصوصاً اس کانفرنس کے لیے انگلینڈ سے تشریف لائے ہیں، میں آپ کی خدمت میں ملتمس ہوں کہ آپ مائک پر تشریف لائیں اور شرکائے کانفرنس جو اس جگہ پر موجود ہیں اور سوشل میڈیا پر ہزار ہا لوگ ہمیں اس وقت دیکھ رہے ہیں، نعرے تکبیر جوش کے ساتھ مہمان کا استقبال جذبے کے ساتھ کریں۔ اب یہ کانفرنس کو اپنے پورے عروج پر پہنچ چکی ہے، نعرے تکبیر، نعرے رسالت، نعرے حیدری، نعرے غوثیہ، تاجدار ختم نبوت۔
والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده، أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، محمد رسول الله، والذين معه أشداء على الكفار رحماء بينهم، تراهم ركعا سجدا يبتغون فضلا من الله ورضوانا، سیماہم فی وجوہہم من اثر السجود، صدق اللہ العظیم۔ پس خدا بر ما شریعت ختم کر، بر رسول ما رسالت ختم کر، لا نبی بعدی ز احسان خدا است، پردہ ناموس دین مصطفیٰ است۔ جانشین نصیر ملت حضرت پیر سید غلام نظام الدین جامی صاحب، علامہ صاحبزادہ برکات احمد چشتی صاحب، ایمیننٹ علماء کرام، مشائخ اعظام، ڈیئر آڈینس، السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ تعالی وبرکاتہ۔ آئی برنگ گریٹنگز ٹو دس ایمیننٹ کانفرنس from my honorable father, the founder of Jamia Al-Karam in the United Kingdom, Peerzada Muhammad Imdad Hussain Sahib. I am extremely humbled to be standing here before you today in the vicinity of Ala Hazrat Sayyiduna Peer Mehre Ali Shah, in the vicinity of Hazrat Nasir-e-Millat, at this very historic place on the face of this earth, where Hazrat Ala Sayyiduna Peer Mehre Ali confronted one of the greatest fitnas that has occurred in this world. And from here he embarked upon his jihad against that fitna. Me, being a very small person, me, being a very person who is not good in knowledge or spirituality, for me to be standing here is a blessing of Allah Ta'ala, and indeed I am humbled and grateful to Hazrat Sahibzada Jami Sahib for asking me and ordering me to be here. In a few minutes, I want to just share some thoughts with you, and I would prefer and I would request your kind attention to the points that I am going to share with you. We are here today to remember and mark one of the greatest victories that has been granted to the Ummah of the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, which is the defense of the Khatam al-Nubuwwat of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The final messenger is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is that fine point upon which the integrity of the whole of Islam depends. That is what we are here to mark on this occasion. I want to share with you some thoughts that what is it that made Ala Hazrat Sayyidina Peer Mehre Ali Shah to take on this fitna? What is the secret of the strength that is within Ala Hazrat Sayyidina Peer Mehre Ali that made him the leader of all of the Muslims of the subcontinent, and let me say more than that, the leader of all of the Muslims of the world in confronting the fitna of Qaeda-e-Aliyah? What is the secret that is hidden within Peer Mehre Ali? That is what I want to share with you. We are followers of the Chishti Tariqa, and the Chishti Tariqa is distinguished with the concept of ishq within it. We are a tariqa of love for the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah Hazrat Sayyidina Peer Mehre Ali Shah is fanafir Rasul as an individual. His ishq Mustafa is such that following the examples of other mashayikh such as Hazrat Sheikh Yahya Madani, we know that Peer Mehre Ali traveled to Madinatul Munawwara and had decided that he was going to stay in Madinatul Munawwara. There he would be in the company of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then there we know, and history tells us, that true inspiration from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Peer Sayyidina Mehre Ali Shah came back to this country, came back to this land, and took on the fitna of Qaeda-e-Aliyah. And how did he do that? Shamsul Hidayah, he wrote. Sayyid Chishtiyai, he wrote two books that we need to be studying. These are conclusive documents on the issue of the finality of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then we are here to mark that occasion in Lahore, where Peer Mehre Ali Shah made his famous statement that put your pen and the paper on the table, and whichever one can command the pen to write itself on the paper, that shall be the fruitful one. How I wish I was there to witness that spectacle when Peer Mehre Ali Shah, with the confidence that comes from Madinatul Munawwara, he stood there and said, get the pen and let the pen write on the paper. How I wish I was standing there. I want to answer the question, what is the strength inside Peer Mehre Ali? And for that, let me take you to Madinatul Munawwara and the Shaksiyat of the Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. We are told in the Ahadith that the Sahaba Ikram told us that they would once on the 14th night look at the moon, the full moon in the desert of Makkah and Medina, the full moon in its splendid glory. The Sahaba say, we would look at the moon, then we would look at the face of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We would look at the moon again, and we would look at the face of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We came to the conclusion that Chehra-e Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam was far more beautiful than the moon. Jamal-e Mustafa is far more beautiful. Sulmati chashm aya in maazad zulf walayn wad duha chehra. We are told in the hadith Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam said, I have been given five things that nobody else has been given, and one of them is nasibtu bi-rawbi masirat shahrin. I have been given robe that the enemy of mine will be at a distance of 1 month from me, and he will fear me. This is robe of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. From these two hadiths we see that amongst the qualities of Mustafa Karim sallallahu alayhi wasallam, one is Jamal of the Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and two is the Jalal of Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Jamal-e-Mustafa and Jalal-e-Mustafa are qualities of the Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. And we all know in Madinatul Munawwara, when the Christians from Najran came to debate with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and the Mubahala occurred, who came with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam? The Rasul brought with him the Panjtan-e-Baq. The Rasul brought with them Imam-e-Hasan, Imam-e-Hussein, Sayyidina Ali al-Murtada, Sayyida Fatima al-Zahra. And the Rasul came, and the enemies of Islam, when they saw Jamal-e-Mustafa in action, Jamal-e-Ahl-e-Bayt in action, when they saw Jalal-e-Mustafa in action, and they saw Jalal-e-Ahl-e-Bayt in action, the Mubahala did not go forward. Victory for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Jamal-e-Mustafa conflict, Jalal-e-Mustafa, which is the strength of this deen. Now I say to you that when Peer Mehre Ali Shah came from Madinatul Munawwara, when he came back to take on the fitna of Qadianiyat, he came with Aqsay Jamal-e-Mustafa and Aqsay Jalal-e-Mustafa, equipped with both of these qualities. Sayyidina Ala Hazrat Peer Mehre Bulandi Shah came to this land, and when he entered the city of Lahore, for 6 days we know what happened. That was a moment in the year 1900 when the people in Lahore, from all schools of thought, all the people in the entire region, they were encapsulated by Jamal ibn Ali. They were sitting in Lahore, and for a few days they were looking at Afzal Jamal Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the surat of Pir Mehre Ali, and the Qadianis and the Mirza himself, he could not come to Lahore because of Afzal Jalal Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam that was resembling in the Afzal in the Jalal of Pir Mehre Ali. And in Mehre Ali is that soul who in this day and age in the world that we are living in reflected Jamal Mustafa. He reflected Jalal Mustafa. When Jamal Mustafa, Jalal Mustafa, Ahle Bayt of the Rasul come together, then the fitna will be evaporated. This is the strength of our Imam that is resting over there. This is the strength of Pir Mehre Ali Shah, that he resembled Jamal Mustafa. He resembled Jalal Mustafa. I am so honored to be here in this company of Hazrat Pir Mehre Ali. Let me finish by saying, Hazrat Pir Mehre Ali Shah, in your company, I said, that we are nobodies in front of you. Let me stand here in this Khatam-e-Nubuwwat campus today and we reaffirm our Iman in the Khatam-e-Nubuwwat of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Mehre Ali, we confirm that we are your followers. Ya Mehre Ali, we confirm that you are our identity. It is you who we follow. It is you who company we want on the Day of Judgment. On Yawm al-Qiyamah, when Mehre Ali is standing there, Rasulullah alayhi salatu wa salam comes. It is my dua here with Nasir al-Millat present, Mehre Ali present, Ulama al-Islam present, my dua. Then on that Day of Judgment, when you stand in front of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, may we be standing with you. May we be standing with you, Mehdi Ali, when you say to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muqtand Badal, Shashaniye, Matte Chand Tehdaar, Nurhaniye, Tahli Zulfateya, Mastaniye, Makmool Akeem, Bin Madbariya, Subhanallah, Ma Ajmalaka, Ma Ahsanaka, Ma Akmalaka, Kitte Mehdi Ali, Kitte Deri Sala, Gustaf Akeem,
حضرت اللہ صاحب زادہ بختیار حیدر میرزادہ صاحب